Breaking news tonight at 6, reaction to dramatic body cam video of a deadly police-involved shooting that happened in May.
Relatives of the man shot and killed have seen that video, and they're using some pretty strong words to describe it. WGN's Tom Negevin has just spoken to the parents of 26-year-old Sherelle Brown. He lives in Garfield Park. Tom.
I'm live in Garfield Park. Yes, Micah and Joe and the family members have just seen the video released just this afternoon by the Office of Police Accountability. They're using some pretty strong words to describe it, as you say. Have a look.
Shoot you!
Now, police say they exchanged gunfire twice with Brown on May 11th in the 1400 block of South Lawndale. They say the first exchange happened after they approached him and spotted a weapon. He ran, they say, and officers caught up with him again, leading to a second exchange of shots. Brown was killed in that exchange, but his family and their lawyers say they see no weapon in the video. And the video makes it clear, they say, the shooting did not happen the way Chicago police say it did.
They murdered my son, and in the video, if you guys look at the video, they'll tell them that before they even, at the beginning of the video, they tell them they're going to kill him, and they went right back in that gangway and did exactly what they said they were going to do. They murdered my son.
I would be satisfied if that officer faced me. That's what I would like for him to do, face me, because the person that you killed, that was my baby.
Now, Chicago police tonight dispute that accounting of events. They say that Sherelle Brown did have a gun on May 11th at the time of that shooting. It was recovered at the scene, and that as of this moment, COPA has not recommended the officer involved be disciplined in any way. They say they are still awaiting a use of force recommendation from the Civilian Office of Police Accountability. Live in Garfield Park, Tom Negevin, WGN News.